lights off, stop calling me John.
I grew up in Adelaide, South Australia. Everyone calls it like a big country town, even though it's not a country town. It's like just so small and intimate and everyone knows each other. There's nothing that really goes on there. Everyone just gets up to all kinds of crazy little shenanigans. I was always out going to house parties and being a little rat bag. I grew up in the house with just me, my mum and my stepdad, and they didn't really give a shit. They're low-key kind of neglectful, but just be like, I don't know where she is or what she's doing, and I'd just be in a field somewhere with a goon bag passed out. It was hectic, actually. Growing up, my stepdad was pretty abusive from ages like 7 to about like 18, 19 when I was growing up with him. It was a pretty neglectful environment growing up in, but we managed. We worked our way through it and, you know, made my way out of it on the other side of things, and I have a better relationship with my mum now. My stepdad's not around at all, so yeah. I can remember writing little songs on little napkins, and like they would have been absolute garbage, but I would write them and I'd go and like hand them out to my family. I'd be like, all right, everybody sit down. This is a little song I've written. Everyone was like, wow. I was like, good job. I was obsessed with Britney Spears, and when I was like really little in the early 2000s, and I would like walk around and try and be like her and sing like her, my mom would get so sick of it because I'd be like singing over her TV shows. And she's like, shut up. So yeah, I've always wanted to sing, and I've always been writing and singing for as long as I can remember. I was 100% convinced. I was like, I am the next thing. Like, I'm going to be a pop star. And I remember telling everyone, they're like, what do you want to be when you grow up? I was like, famous. I was like, I want to be a pop star. And they're like, okay, but like, realistically, what else? And I was like, no, that's it. I remember having like a full on conversation with my mom in high school, and I was like crying my eyes out. She was like, I know you want to be a singer and you're very good and all, but I think maybe we should have some more realistic goals. Is there something else you want to try as well? And I was like, why can't I just be a famous pop star? And she's like, you can, but that's just really difficult. And I like had never even considered that it wasn't an option before. So that was like the first time that I was like, oh, maybe I can't just go and be a pop star after high school. When I got a bit older in like high school, I started posting song covers on Facebook. Like I would do like singing videos on Facebook, and I did like a ton of them. I did them all the time. But just be like friends and family that would see them. One of them randomly blew up and it got, I think, like 20,000 likes or something. For me, that was like massive. I was like, what the hell? Like, it's out of nowhere. I was like, I've gone viral. Like, I was so excited. I did Australia's Got Talent. I did X Factor. The Voice was the other one. I did everything I could. I also used to do a local talent show. I did that like 2 or 3 years in a row, and I sang original songs there, and I won the songwriting thing. Like, I got a studio session. I got to record a song that I'd written. That was the first time I'd ever been in a studio and ever had anything professionally recorded, and I won it through that like local talent show thing. And it was a song called One Day, and it was about me being bullied at school, and literally the song was called One Day because I was singing about how I'm gonna make it big one day, and that was the chorus. And I was like, don't bully me, I'll make it big one day, I promise, like I'm gonna do so well.
And you will make it someday, just keep working at it, you know, get your lessons, keep writing, and you know, sky's the limit. So, you know what, you're absolutely right
this year. And that was the first song I ever recorded in a professional studio. And then I think from there, a lot of people from my school like found it, and then I did get bullied a little bit for that. And I just got bullied at school in general, like not even for singing, just for being a kid, I guess, because kids are mean. But, and I probably wasn't the nicest kid in school anyway. Like, I think sometimes we fall into like a victim complex and we forget that when we're bullied, we also bully other people. So yeah, I was being bullied a lot, and I probably was bullying other people as well. So that's what my song was about, was about bullying. That was pretty much what, like growing up. And then from there, I dropped out of school and like, because of everything going on at home. And then I moved out and lived with my dad for a bit, like my real dad. And we had a lot of money and I was struggling a lot, so I started stripping. That was a pretty rough gig for like 4 years I did that. And when my dad found out, he kicked me out. So I was homeless and stripping, and it was a pretty rough like 4 years for me. It was just like a series of unfortunate events. That specific era was just like one thing after the other was just like miserable. Like there'd just be horrible, horrible things happening, and I'd be like, what the hell? Like, what is going on? And I ended up staying in the hospital for a little bit. I got discharged from the hospital and had nowhere to go. Like, my dad had kicked me out. My mom had moved off with her new boyfriend, didn't want anything to do with me. And then my sister had kicked me out. So I just took any rental, and it was like one, like five dudes, and I hadn't even met them. It was just the only place that was available that would allow pets. So I was like, I'll take it. I'll be there tomorrow. Like, I just need somewhere to go. I was so poor. I had this one loaf of bread that had like gone stale, but it wasn't moldy yet. So I put it in the freezer, and every day I would like defrost one piece of bread to eat so that I could like survive. Like, it was so bad. And so I was like devastated. And I actually like gave up for a little bit, because I was like, oh, well, I guess if it's going to be too hard and there's so many people that want to do it, it's like a one in a million chance. But, you know, what's the point? So I just stopped for a bit. But because of everything I went through, like, I had to pick it up again, because I was like, I need something to hold on to. Otherwise, I'll just fall apart, and I'm so thankful that I did. while I was going through that like really horrible time, I was like, I just need something to make me feel better. And like, I remember feeling so rewarded from writing and like getting my feelings out. So I wrote this one song, and like I hadn't written in like maybe a year or two at that point. And I posted that, and a bunch of people were like, oh my God, this is so cool, I love this. And it just gave me like this huge rush of euphoria. I was like, oh my God, like people like my music and what I'm writing. And it was kind of like addicting. I was like, oh my God, I want to feel that again. So I started writing more and more. And then it was just constant. It was like the only thing that would bring me any kind of like uplifting energy. So I just do it all the time. And I think within like a month or two, I flew out to the US to meet a producer and made Blondes, and the first single that I put out.
I'm hard to love, there's no denying.
There was actually a bunch of labels, like kind of all at once, that reached out, because I guess through TikTok that kind of spiked overnight almost, and then everyone found my music through that. And I think then labels were reaching out to me. I didn't have any management, like not even for TikTok or anything. I was just doing it all on my own, just like for fun. Like literally as I was having those phone calls, like with Brett from Republic and with, you know, Adam, like my manager, I was like sitting on a mattress with no sheet on it, like on the floor, like in my old house in Adelaide. I had like garbage bags behind me on my Zoom calls. Like it was just like, when it all happened, it was just like, okay, now there's a label that's made a deal, and now there's management, and now there's all this stuff happening, and we're going to get you in demos, and we're going to fly out to Sydney. And I was just like, what the hell? Like, this is just so unreal. I'd want to be the next like Ariana Grande, like all right there alongside her. Like that would be my dream, and be like this crazy, like world famous pop star if I could do anything. But it's like I keep saying, like anything I'm so happy with, and I'm just here along for the ride, and everything has been so exciting and so crazy so far. So whatever I can get, or whatever I've already got is more than enough. So yeah, but if I can, I'll take it as far as I can go.